The nomination of a former Philippine Energy Secretary to the post he once held hits a snag. Rafael Lutilia was chosen by President Marcos Jr. to handle the department he previously led from 2005 to 2007 during the Arroyo administration. But just hours after the announcement, Malacañang clarified Lutilia has yet to be officially appointed while it tries to clarify his employment status. Lutilia is currently an independent director of Apuetis Power and ACE Enexor. Philippine law prohibits an officer of any private energy company from being appointed as energy chief within 2 years from his retirement, resignation, or separation from the firm. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. said to be making a complete recovery days after coming down with COVID for a second time. In the latest health bulletin of Marcos's lead physician, Dr. Samuel Zacate, he said the president's vital signs are all within normal limits and exemplary. He adds the fast recovery is expected from a fully vaccinated individual with a good health status. The president is set to call for a second cabinet meeting this Tuesday morning, which he is expected to attend virtually as he is still in home isolation.
President Marcos Jr. Security Group has started preparations for his first ever State of the Nation address later this month. The PSG held an interagency meeting on Monday, led by PSG Commander Colonel Ramon Zagala. Representatives of the military, police, Bureau of Fire Protection, Coast Guard, Airport and Aviation Authorities, Health Department, and the National Intelligence Coordinating Agency attended the meeting. Under the Constitution, the SONA is delivered every fourth Monday of July when Congress opens its regular session. Budget Secretary Benjamin Jokno earlier said Marcos would unveil his administration's economic game plan in his first SONA. The Philippines State Auditor orders the Local Water Utilities Administration to expedite the release of unused disaster funds and to restore normal supply of potable water in areas affected by Super Typhoon Yolanda, as well as the conflicts in Marawi and Zamboanga City. A 2021 report by the Commission on Audit showed over 11 billion pesos from the Yolanda Recovery and Rehabilitation Plan have yet to be dispersed to water districts. A bigger amount of over 441 million pesos also remain unutilized by Liwa in Zamboanga City. More than 143 million pesos meant for the improvement of the water supply and sewage system in Marawi City has yet to be released. The management of Lua admits the COVID-19 pandemic has disrupted its work in these areas.
1.4 billion pesos, that's how much the Philippine Transportation Department needs to extend free bus rides along Metro Manila's EDSA Highway until the end of the year. The government reportedly spends around 10 million pesos daily for the free ride scheme. The program offers free rides for commuters from Caloocan City to the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange.
Yung pong libreng sakayin dyan sa EDSA Carousel, no? Merong certain budget. Tutuloy po natin yan hanggang December. No? We will need an additional budget of around 1.4 billion. Kung kailangan natin ituloy hanggang December 31, we will ask for additional budget from the Department of Budget and Management. So hihingi po kami ng tulong sa Presidente para magkaroon ng ganyang budget para sa DOTR.
A Philippine transport advocacy group worried the public transport sector is not yet ready for the resumption of physical classes. The Passenger Forum is suggesting ways to address the impending high demand for public transport. These include adding more public utility vehicles along transport routes and allowing carpooling. The Transportation Department says it is already anticipating a heavier traffic flow and high passenger volume when the school season opens.
Coordination na yung preparation namin sa face-to-face classes, no, ay hindi lang tungkol sa kakulungan ng mga sasakyan but also traffic, no. Kaya nga we will have to work closely with MMDA, with PNP, with AFP, no, with Coast Guard, no, para yun hong traffic ay also matulungan natin na mabawasan, no? Or hindi masyadong maging maluba yung traffic situation dito sa Metro Manila, lalo na sa Metro Manila.
Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista says he is willing to ride on public buses and jeepneys himself to personally experience the daily ordeal of Filipino commuters.